Yeah.
Hi, I'm Jim Stone, and welcome to KNSD's Aztec Football Preview. There are high hopes for San Diego State this season. It's a team coming off three consecutive winning seasons, a first since joining the Western Athletic Conference. And many experts are predicting a conference championship this year. The road to making those predictions come true begins in training camp, where the motto is mental toughness, and the way to achieve that is through a lot of hard work.
My H vertical, vertical, card play on one on one. Ready?
Better, good.
It turns into a long, hot summer once training camp begins.
It's
not hard.
But this is a team on a mission to prove it belongs in big-time college football. And the opportunity is there. The Aztecs face the toughest schedule in the school's history. But with 14 returning starters, the team has matured and should only build on last year's success, coming within 1 point of a WAC title. Of course, the man in the spotlight is running back Marshall Faulk, arguably the best rusher in college football today. Faulk is coming off a tremendous freshman year. And despite the fact he wasn't a starter when last season began and he missed several games with broken ribs, Faulk still had enough highlights to fill a career.
Draw play, here he comes, 25 to the 20, good breaks a tackle to the 15.
Feel good, you know, to block for him because it's like you just give him a little crease, a little crack, and he'll just squirm through and just touchdown.
I think he's a great football player. He's a great back. He's tough, he's strong, he's quick. And he's a big difference in that football team because he is a threat every time he touches the ball.
Marshall Faulk is a special person who, if people and young people out there can emulate him, do it, because he's got what it takes to be successful, not just on the football field, but in life.
He's something special. The more you watch Marshall Faulk run with the football last season, the more you are amazed. 1,429 yards, 21 touchdowns. What can he do for an encore? Let's ask him. Let's ask the man himself. He joins me right now. Marshall, what about it? Your sophomore year obviously will be much tougher. Defenses are going to gear up for you. Eight-man fronts. How much tougher will it be for you?
Well, it will be a lot tougher. We've been preparing for it. We got a lot of new things in the offense. We've got some great receivers and a great quarterback in David Lowry, an offensive line that's going to protect real good and defend when they put up eight men.
Certain running backs, whether it be in college football, pro football, wherever, just have that knack of being able to break clear and break free, and big gainers come off of it. You're one of those backs. What do you think about when you get the ball in your hands and you see daylight?
Well, as I see daylight, there's a lot of things that you think about. You look up the safety and you try to read and see what he's going to do. But it's kind of hard because they got a lot of other players around you. But as the game goes on, you start to get a feel of what the safety is going to do, and then that big one finally settles in and you score it.
Your eyes light up when you see a hole?
Yes, indeed.
No doubt about it. When you talk about this season and this season coming up, you're already being billed as a Heisman Trophy candidate, maybe third on the list right now. It's a question you're going to be asked throughout the season. Number one, what would it mean if you could win it? And number two, I'm amazed, you're very level-headed. You don't have a big head. A lot of people are saying you're great, you're this, you're that. How do you stay on that even keel?
Well, as far as for the Heisman Trophy, I look at that as a team-orientated thing. If the team do what we have to do to be in the top 25, to win all 11-hour games, to win the WAC, well, there's a possibility for me to win the Heisman Trophy. And as for turning pro, I have some goals in college to fulfill, and one of them is to get a college education.
All right, Marshall Faulk, thank you very much. He is definitely a team player and one heck of a running back. Well, just like Marshall Faulk, the rest of the Aztecs' offense will be under pressure to live up to last year's success. The team was sixth in the nation in total offense, averaging more than 478 yards a game. And the man who will lead them again is junior quarterback David Lowry.
Proven something all my life. You know, they don't believe 6 foot quarterbacks play football, but I'm out here to prove them that they can.
Despite his success a year ago, David Lowry's out to prove his worth again as a major college quarterback.
481 X-Blood, I want it.
The 2,500 yards and 19 touchdowns he threw for as a sophomore are just a memory, although they're definitely the numbers of a winner. Lowry spent the offseason improving his strength. He knows what it'll take to improve his game.
He can improve every game, making the right decisions, throwing to the right people all the time, and cutting down on my interceptions. That's basically what will make him a better quarterback.
Lowry's favorite target is number 6, Darnay Scott. The speedy sophomore is now the Aztecs' number 1 receiver. Keith Williams is another deep threat who displayed some great promise at the end of last season.
Oh, yeah. Swing.
With the big play potential of Larry Maxey at both H-back and running back.
Oh, yeah.
Along with Marshall Faulk's understudy Wayne Pittman, the Aztecs have plenty of weapons offensively. No matter how much talent you have at the skill positions, to be a successful offense, you need the big guys up front. And believe me, the Aztecs have that in Joe Hines, Carson Leomidi, and Tony Nichols, anchoring their offensive line.
Because if Marshall could run, he could be the best runner in the world, which he probably is. And if the line's not giving him holes, he's not going to do anything. If they give us the holes and give me the time to throw, we can do some damage, hopefully.
Hey, believe me, folks, I was scared in front of those offensive linemen. Explosive, that's definitely the way to describe the Aztecs' offense. A lot more to come here on KNSD's Aztec Football Preview. When we return, a look at the defense, which plans to make up in aggressiveness what it lacks in experience. And then we'll show you